Deep Space Warship UMS Bodega Bay, requesting a priority translight communication with UMS Sector Control.
Bodega Bay, this is Starlight Base. Go ahead.
Starlight Base, we picked up a life pod of alien origin as we came into orbit. There was one human survivor aboard who claims to have escaped from the planet. Survivor will not disclose identity even under interrogation. DNA scans are being uploaded for identification. Please advise.
Stand by, Bodega Bay. Bodega Bay, your survivor is UMS Prisoner 849, last assigned to Prisoner Transport Vessel Vortex Rikers. Vortex Rikers recently disappeared in your sector. Prisoner 849 is classified as missing and presumed dead.
Starlight Base, permission to use the rescued prisoner for Operation Talon Hunter. The prisoner has extensive knowledge of the planetary surface and hazards. Prisoner 849 is the natural choice to search for the wreck of the Prometheus and recover the Talon data cores.
Bodega Bay, you are cleared to take whatever steps are necessary to ensure the success of Operation Talon Hunter.
A day after my so-called rescue, and I'm going back to the surface of the planet. They've promised me a full pardon and transit back to Earth in exchange for my help. The alternative was a trip out the airlock without a suit. I agreed to take the mission. My job is to find the wreck of another ship, the Prometheus, and recover the data cores for some new secret weapons research project. When I've got the cores, I'm supposed to go to the bridge of the crashed ship and activate the ELT transmitter. The ELT will pinpoint my location for pickup. They need me because they don't know exactly where the Prometheus went down. Apparently the pteridium in the planet below is wreaking havoc with their scanners. They figure I learned a thing or two during my last romp on the surface. If anyone can find their missing ship, I can. I'm a little better prepared than last time. They've given me a military-issue combat assault rifle, a new portable scuba unit for underwater, and this computer log. They've also made logistics drops of ammo, weapons, and other supplies. So, I did it before, and I'll do it again. But it won't be easy. They call this a salvage mission. I call it a return to hell. After a leap of faith, I'm pausing to record a log entry. I'm still shaken up after running into the Scar and their filthy minions. I guess I thought I'd seen the last of them when I killed the Scar Queen on the mothership. Seems like an eternity ago. Is there another colony nearby? Where are they coming from? This is like a recurring nightmare. Still no sign of the Prometheus. Time to move on.
Yeah.
I'm glad I figured out how to bring water back into the underground well system. The Nolly won't die of thirst. And it's a good thing the scuba gear worked so well. I wouldn't have made it without the new equipment. Much as I hate being back here, I have to say it was good to see the Nolly again. I believe I'm getting closer to the Prometheus. I can feel it.
Huh!
I'm close. I've seen the first evidence of the crash site. During a tough slog through a Nali village infested with Scar, I came across pieces of a crashed Terran ship. The debris was seared from re-entry and scattered over a wide area. I hope she didn't break up in the air. If she did, there won't be any cores to recover. The crash site is very close. I'm nearly home free.